we have discussed file permissions. There are two types of file permissions: absolute file permission and relative file permissions. Unix has simple and well-defined system of assigning permissions to files. We have discussed file permissions. Unix has simple and well-defined system of assigning permissions to files. For example, consider ls-l command to view the permission of a few files given in below example. ls-l chapter 2 space department1.lst data dateval.sh are three different files that possible to provide display the permissions and with the owner, with the group owner, date of and how many bytes and what type of files that should be displayed by system. First column in the above output represents file permissions. These permissions are also different for the three files. Unix follows three-tier file protection system that determines the file access rights. Under how the system works, let us break up into permission string of the file chop 2 into three groups. The initial -n, the first column, represents the directory file and left out of the permission strings. RWX and R-X and R-, each group represents category and contain three slots representing read, write and execute permissions of file in that order. R indicates read permission, which means cat can display the file. W indicate write permission. We can edit such file with an editor. X indicates execute permission. The file can execute as a program. And -n shows absence of corresponding permissions. The first group in that example, RWX, has all three permissions given to the user, the readable, write and executable by the owner. The third column shows Kumar as a owner, and first permission group applies the Kumars. We have to log in with the username Kumar for these privileges to apply to us. The second group, R-X, has -n in the middle slot, which indicate absence of write permission by group owner of the file. This group owner is here group owner is Metal, and all user belonging to the Metal group has read and write permissions only. The third group, R-, has only read permissions. This set's permissions is applicable to others. That is, those who are neither the owner nor belong to the Metal group. This category is often referred to as the world. The file is not world writable. Thank you. Here, this figure shows three general type of access of file permissions. R indicate read, W indicate write, X indicate execute. To check the read, write and execute permissions for users, group and others are shown in the figure. To check the permissions of an existing file or an existing directory, use the command ls-l. Here we discuss change the permission of file. In Unix, a file or a directory is created with default set of permissions. Generally, the default set write protect a file from all except the user, nothing but owner of the file. Here, the permission of the file can be changed using the command chmod command. Here, change mode command is used to set the permissions of one or more files for all three categories of users, group, and others. Usually, in this first figure that shows chmod options, nothing but that consider recursively, you write R recursively, and mode is you are using relative mode or absolute mode, right? That applicable for file or directory. And second figure shows change mode should be applicable for relative permissions. Here in the relative permissions, when changing the permission in relative manner, chmod only changes the permission specified in the command line and leaves all other permissions unchanged. In this mode, it uses the following syntax: change mode category, nothing but who are the operators, user, group, others, or all. Then operation or operators, permission is considered. You can using add or remove or anything else, or you are not permitted. Then permission is read, write, or execute permissions. In the expression that contains three components, write, one is nothing but a category, user category, right? Operation consider assign or remove the permissions, nothing but plus means assign, minus means remove. And the type of permissions, nothing but applicable read, write, or execute permissions. For example, in that figure shows change mode, user is U is equal to nothing but user, applicable for read, write, and execute. Okay, your group that shows not added the right permissions. In the others also we are using write permissions. That should be changed for existing file memo.doc. In this slide that shows change file permissions with an example. Generally, default setting write protects a file from all except the user. Here is example cat /user/bin/start --stats, nothing but actually copies the file stats, nothing but to start. If this command shows file stats, ls -l xstats, that indicate to show the what type of permissions given to the file xstat. Here the first one is the ordinary file, first column hyphen indicate ordinary file, and read write permission, execute permission is not given. Second is the second group, only read permission. Third group also only read permission. And then one link is there from Kumar, and the group is metal group, and the size of the file, it should be stored in which day and what type of file it is. In the above output that seems by default a file does not also have execute permissions. Okay, the permission of file can be changed using chmod command. Here in this example, change mode command used to set the permission of one or more files all three categories, nothing but user, group and others. It can also run only by user, nothing but the owner and the super users. Remember, it can run only by user or and super users. The command can be used in two different ways. One is a relative manner by specifying the changes to the current permissions, and absolute manner by specifying the final permissions. The slide shows relative permissions. When changing permission in relative manner, we are using command change mode. Only changes the permission specified in the command line and leaves all other permissions unchanged. In this mode, it uses the following syntax: change, category, operation permission, file name or file names. Change chmode takes its argument an expression comprising some letters and symbols that completely describes the user category and type permissions being assigned or removed. The expression contains the components user category, user or a group or others. The operation to be performed, nothing but you want to assign the permission, remove the permission, or assign absolute type of permissions. The third type of permission is third one is the permissions, nothing but R refers read permission, W refers write permission, X refers execute permissions. By using suitable abbreviations for each of these components, we can form compact expressions and then use it as argument to the command chmode. The abbreviations used for these three components are shown in below table. Here in this slide, we take an example to assign execute permission to the user of the file x.txt. We need to frame a suitable expression by using appropriate character from each of the three columns of the above table. Since the field need to execute only by the user, the expression required is u plus x. For example, change mode u plus x, space x dot, execute this command. After that, you can call ls minus l x dot command and execute that command that shows the permission of the corresponding file x dot. The command assigns plus executes plus execute permission to the user, but other permissions remain unchanged when you go for using u plus x. We can now execute the file if you are the owner of the file, but other categories, nothing but group and others, are still cannot change. To enable all of them execute this file, we have to use multiple character to represent the user category UGO. For that, you type change mode UGO plus X starts and put semicolon, then write ls minus l starts. That is a combination of two commands, UGO plus X and start, then ls minus X start. That should be execute both the commands at once. Then after that, that changes, that shows the output is rwx and r-x and r-x. Okay, that should be changed from the previous one. Here in this slide, that shows chmode command accept multiple file names in command line. When you need to assign the same set of permission to group of files, this is what we should do. You are applying chmod, nothing but change mode command u plus x node space node 1 space node 3. Permissions are removed with the minus operator to remove the read permission from both the group and others. Use expression go minus r. ls minus l starts that indicate that show the current existing file information. Here rewrite execute and read and execute and read and execute for groups. Then we apply change mode go minus r x starts and then called ls minus l command. Both combined commands are executed. Then the output shows whatever the user consider rewrite and execute, whatever r is there that is removed from the group and also r is from others, right? In the previous example x minus r minus x and r minus x is there. Here output is hyphen hyphen x hyphen hyphen x that indicate we are remove the read permission for group and others. Okay, change mode also accept multiple expression delimited by commas. For instance, to restore the original permission for the file extract, we have to remove the execute permission from all. For that, you write a-x and assign read permission to the group and others, write go plus r. For that, you write change mode a minus x, nothing but you remove the execute permission from all and go plus r that indicate assign read permission to group and others of x dot file and put semicolon then write ls minus l start, nothing but combine these two commands and execute it. Okay, combining command format. And that shows whatever previous one is there, read, write, execute for users. Here that shows read and write, not execute. And then here execute command for user and others that should be changed by only for read, and read permissions are given to the group and others. Right? Like that we are possible to go for change to apply whatever need, which one is need you can add, which one is not required you can remove. Like that we can do all type of permissions can be done using in the above example, like that in the above example. Here we are discuss about absolute permissions. Using absolute permissions we can set all 9 permission bits explicitly to express used by chmod command. Here a string of 3 octal numbers, nothing but base 8. Octal numbers use the base 8, the octal digit have the value 0 to 7. This means that set of 3 bits can represent 1 octal digit. If you represent the permission for each category by 1 octal digit, this is how the permission can be represented. For read operation, we set 4, nothing but 100 in octal. For write permission, 2, in that octal you represent 010. For execute permission, 1, in octal we represent 001. For each category, we add up the numbers. This slide that shows all type of representation using in octal digits. For instance, 6 represents read and write permissions and 7 represents all permission, as can easily be understood from the following table. 000 that indicate no permissions, no read write permissions. 001 that indicate only executable permissions. 010 that indicate only writable permissions. 011 that indicate writable and executable permissions. 100 that indicate only readable permissions, 101 that file that indicate readable and executable permissions, 110 that indicate readable and writable permissions, all 111 that represent 7 that indicate readable, writable and executable permissions. We have three category and three permissions for each category, so three octal digits can describe the file permission completely. The most significant digit represents user and the least one represents others. For using the command change mode, we can use three digit string as the permissions. We can use this method to assign read and write permission to all three categories. For example, change mode 666 x dot semicolon ls minus l starts. Now nothing but you want to go for change, you want to set the set read write and read write operation for all three categories for the x dot file using existing subdirectory command. The 6 indicates read and write permissions, 4 plus 2 to restore the original permission to the file. We need to remove the write permission 2 from the others. Then want to go for using change mode 644 x start, then ls minus l start that indicate that remove the executable content from the write content from the existing or write permission from the existing one. Then that represents a read write from the user and only read from remaining two type of others, nothing but to assign the permission to the owner, read and write, and to group only other permissions for that you go perform the operations. In this slide, our goal is to set the mode of file KMS to a specific format. For example, read, write and execute permission to the owner, and read and execution permission to the group, and only execution permission to the others. Like that, we set a mode for the file KMS. For that, we want to go for write rwx slash r hyphen x slash hyphen hyphen x in relative permissions. For that, we go for change the mode using change mode command. For you write rwx, nothing but give the permission of read, write and execute permission to the owner, and then g is equal to rx, nothing but only permission given to the group is read and execute, and o is equal to x, nothing but only execution permission given to the others in the file KMS. For that, you set change mode u is equal to rwx, g is equal to rx, comma o is equal to x space KMS, and enter that change the mode in relative permission. The same thing should be performed in absolute permission. For that, we are using chmode 751 space KMS. Chmode space 751 space KMS and enter this command execute, perform the same operation. What is our goal to set the mode for file KMS? Here one more example for changing the permission in octal mode. For that, type a command ls minus l sort.c. You want to write the ordinary file with all three type of permission in the owner and the user, and only not permitted for a write operation in others. Like that, we are setting mode. For that, list should be desired setting like that, rwx pipe or WX pipe or -X. You can assign a binary values for same thing with the help of 111 pipe 111 pipe symbol 101. You will go for refer the same thing in octal values 421, 421 and 401 that indicate convert into octal values in 3 digit form 775. Write the command change mode 775 sort.c. I think this clears your all doubts how to write octal mode for changing the permission for a given file. In this slide, that shows how to use chmod command recursively. The minus R option makes chmod descend a directory hierarchy and apply the expression to every file and subdirectory it finds. Change mode minus R A plus X shell scripts. This makes all files and subdirectories found in the three walk nothing but that comments from the shell script and shell directories executable by all users. We can provide multiple directory and file names. If you want to use chmod on our home directory tree, then cd to it and use it in one of the way, right? Change mode minus R 755 work with hidden files also. Change mode minus R A plus X star leaves out hidden files. In this slide, we discuss how to set directory permissions. Directories also have their own permissions, and the significance of these permissions differ from those of ordinary files. The read and write access to the directory file are also influenced by the permission of the directory housing them. It is possible that a file cannot be accessed even though it has a read permission and can be removed even if it is write protected. Consider the example make directory cprogsl semicolon ls ld cprogs1 then that indicate that shows default permission for directory in the example read write execute read and execute or 755 permissions for directory. A directory must never be writable by group and others. Here in slide how to change file ownership. There are two commands meant to change ownership of a file or a directory. First one chown, second one chgrp. Chown nothing but change file owners. The command is used in this way: chown option owner write within the bracket colon group and corresponding file names. Chown change owner transfer the ownership of a file to the user. Chown command requires user ID UID of a recipient followed by one or more file names. Changing ownership requires super user permission. For that, you use the command su and enter the root password. Then your command prompt should be appeared as hash sign. After the password successfully entered, su returns hash prompt. Now change the ownership of the file note to Sharma. We can change chown in the following way. Nothing but ls-l note the file name, right? That returns the particular format of what is the permissions of existing file note. Then you want to change the permission CHOWN Sharma node, then write semicolon ls minus l node, then combining the command of these two, then entered, then returned the specific information about whatever Kumar is there previously, that should be changed by Sharma. Kumar should be changed by Sharma in the existing file. Then you want to quit out from the environment. For that you write exit command in ash, then it back to the normal of dollar sign. To change both owner and group, CHOWN can be used as follows: CHOWN Sharma colon DBA space department LSD. That changes the overall thing. Here we are discuss about changing group owners. For that we are using CHGRP. By default, the group owner of a file is group to which the group belongs. The CHGRP change group command changes the file group owner. The below example, Kumar changes the group ownership to ship of DEPTLST to DBA. No super user permission is required for doing this. Further, you type ls-l department.lst, the display, the permissions, permission format, and also display Kumar, and metal is the group owner. Then you want to type the command chgrp dba deptlst semicolon ls-l deptlst. That changes metal to DBA. Nothing but changing the group owner in the previous one is a metal. That should be changes to DBA after execution of a CHGRP command.